Hi, it's Roslyn Reynolds again. I've been asked to tell people what that first day is like and what they can expect when you lose your loved one. I remember the fear just gripping my heart when I got the phone call that my husband was being taken to the hospital. I remember pleading all the way as I drove to the hospital that things would be okay. I remember pretending that everything was okay as I called my children and the people that needed to know that he was in the hospital. I remember the sudden fog that descended when I was told he didn't make it. And that denial that I couldn't believe it, that I didn't want to believe it, that it couldn't be true. I remember those feelings. I remember my mind just slowing to a stop and that inability to think. On that first day, just have to survive. You just take one moment at a time. Drink, breathe, cry. Just be present in your feelings and allow those feelings to wash over you. You don't have to be strong. People think they have to be strong on that day. You don't. Let somebody else take over. Let someone else make the phone calls. Let someone else answer all the phone calls. Find somebody safe that can hold you. You may go through shock. You may need to be wrapped up in a blanket and get warmed up. Drink a lot of water. But don't feel like you have to be the strong one that day. Allow others to care for you. There will be people who come who want to help you. Allow them to help you. Touch is important. A lot of people say that those hugs on that day just lifted them and filled them. And I know some people, it's difficult, you don't want that touch, but that's okay. But as soon as you can allow it, realize that touch is important, and touch helps us to release some of those negative emotions and those toxins that come into the body when you're confronted with a shock, like the death of a loved one. You're going through something that nobody wants to go through, and something that will change your life drastically. But there are people around you who want to help you. Accept that help. Let them be there for you. And just work on surviving today. Weep when you need to. Sleep when you need to. And know that those of us who've been through this are there to help you too. This is Roslyn Reynolds, hoping to help you find hope and healing and happiness once more.